Filipino business grow. He watched the sales, he looked at the Facebook, and he said, look at all this momentum. And he really wasn't planning on coming back to the Philippines to the National Gala. And he threw me off guard and he said, Sean, I want to come back. I want to see the Filipino people. I want to be part of this momentum run. And I said, just tell me when and where and I'll book your ticket. He says, I'm coming for your birthday. I will be at the November LT. And guess what? That is today. Who is my father? Mr. David. Sir David, he is the man that started this all. He is the man that started Lifestyles with a simple dream to make a better life for himself and, more importantly, for his family. He did this all for his family, and that is what has led us to this place we are today. When he started his company 26 years ago, that was a simple man's dream. But now that dream has turned into a mission. A mission to help tens of millions of people change their lives for their families. Everyone in this room knows what this company means to them. So this is our opportunity to hear from him and how he started this company. How it started and where we have come to today. He is the man that we are all here because of today. He has changed each and every one of our lives for the better. He's going to continue to help us grow. So please stand on up and help me welcome our chairman, our founder, Mr. David Nomura.
Every story is unique. What I'm about to do
share a little bit of my story with you. My story, let's go back to the early days when I was growing up. I grew up in Toronto, Canada. Everyone know where Canada is? It's cold there this time of year. Anyways, I grew up in Toronto, Canada, average middle-class family. Grew up, went to school, went to university, and I met the love of my life, what I call my high school sweetheart. And all through high school, I was so proud to have a girlfriend. And then, after 8 years of going steady and madly in love, when I was 25, I got married. The best part of getting married was the arrival of our first child, Sean. And then number two came. That was really exciting. Two children. But life's a journey. And life holds the unknown for us. And things happen in life that you never expect. And it's never a straight line. And the reason why it isn't a straight line, we are thrown curves because I guess I figured out because we learn from them. We learn from our experiences. And some of them are not so good, and some of them are great. And life was great for me. Life was just unbelievable. I was so happy. And then my wife developed breast cancer. And oh wow. For 2.5 years, she suffered. She went through chemotherapy, radiation, and unfortunately, I was 30 years old, 33, and she passed away. Here I was, left with two children, 5 and 3. And to be quite honest with you, I was a great parent, but up until that day, I had never changed a diaper. Boy, did I learn. I learned how to change diapers, how to put kids to bed, how to bathe kids, and last but not least, how to dress them. I had an experience of my lifetime. It was a tough experience. It was a real tough experience because I was a single parent back in the 80s. And being a single parent back in the 80s was very, very unusual because nowadays, people separate, they go their own way. Back then, nobody separated. More like the Philippines, you know, you stay married for life the way it's supposed to be. Anyways, life journey was pretty incredible. And I was pretty emotionally distraught, you know, for the first year. And then, approximately a year and a half after, I got a call from my sister-in-law. My sister-in-law, she lived in Atlanta, Georgia. I live in Toronto. Atlanta, Georgia is in the United States. It's about 3,000 kilometers from my home. It would be a 3-hour plane ride. Not conceivable just to go over just like that because it's quite a distance away. And she said to me, I just met the most phenomenal man, and he has something that I want you to see. I think it's really, really important that you speak to this man. And tomorrow, in your city, this gentleman's coming to your city, and he will be speaking to you and telling you about something that I want you to hear. So, it was at a local hotel in my city, and I went. It was 7 o'clock. And there was about 8 other people in the room. I didn't know exactly what I was going to, but I trusted my sister-in-law. And then it started. A gentleman came out. He was an older gentleman, quite sincere, quite extraordinary. And what he was doing is he was telling us about a new phenomenon that had just come out.
Back in the 80s, we didn't have anything called bottled water, because all we had was tap water. You turned on your tap, and you got a glass of water, and you drank it. That's how we did it. But in our water, there's minerals. The governments all throughout the world put chlorine in our water. Our water, our drinking water, was not pure. We didn't know in the 80s about purified water. We didn't understand. But when you tasted a glass of water that was purified, it was no taste. And that's the way water should be. And what had happened in the 80s was this company invented the water filter. And it was quite simple. You attach this water filter to a tap, and water poured out of your spout, and it came out, but because of the manufacturing of the cylinder, it had carbon in it, and carbon takes away all the minerals, and it had a little bit of gold also, but that's not as important how it worked, but it was a phenomenon. It was water. And then the guy went to the blackboard, and then he started explaining what he's here for. I thought it was the water filter, but he wanted to explain something called the marketing plan. Well, I didn't understand what he was talking about, but I soon understood very, very quickly. He was talking about network marketing. And this gentleman absolutely surprised me. He asked one question that caught my attention, and it wasn't until he asked the question, how many people, and there was only about nine of us in that room, how many people would prefer to earn 1% of 100 people rather than 100% of yourself? Obviously, 1% of 100 people is very, very attractive. And he said, we have a system. We have a way in which you can earn money on many, many people. And it's called network marketing. Then he went to the blackboard, and he started writing down furiously. Well, there's you, and does anyone in this room know five people? We all know five people. Well, if you know five people, get them to know, everyone of them know five people. And he started writing circles. And I didn't realize circles were people. And five people, and you guys have seen this before. And then he said, well then, those five people who you just brought in, they bring in five more people. So now you got five people, and five is 25. And then he said to me, and then 25, then he's bringing five people. And 25 times five, 125. Wow. And then he said, you should have bring in five people. That's 625. And then he said again, you should have bring in five people. That's 3,125. And he said, right now, you've got 4,000 people working for you, all making you money. And I was scratching my head. I had no clue what he was talking about. However, he gave me the brochure, the booklet. I went home. And boy, did I get excited. Two nights I didn't sleep. I was counting my money. I was excited. I was elated. Here was my opportunity. This was it. My friends, that was my introduction to network marketing. I joined as a distributor. Now I'm a distributor. In the first 6 months of my distribution, I became the lead distributor in Canada. I was making a phenomenal amount of money, my friends. I don't want to go into too much of how my real estate, or I'm sorry, my MLM career went, but I was very successful. And because of my success, I had an opportunity travel. And I was traveling only in those days to bring in new people, to get them into the organization, to help them share my experience, my water filter. This was my time. And I was young and excited. And I remember when I traveled, the excitement I felt was a different one. It was an uplifting experience because I was uplifting other people, and it was quite extraordinary. But on my travels, I remember going to St. Louis, Missouri. And I went to St. Louis, Missouri, again, a couple hours from my home in my plane. And I went there to talk to people. I had a downline in St. Louis, and I went to support him. And of course, just like you people, I went there, and there was a meeting, and there was hundreds of people. And this gentleman that I went to meet, who had these hundreds of people at this meeting, he was a baker. He was a small baker, had a little bake shop. But he also did water filters on the side. It was a part-time business. And his bake shop was small, and he wasn't doing very well. So he was looking for a new opportunity. But to go back to my story, during that year and a half, I was very sad after my wife passed away. And I was this human. And how I conquered my sadness is I ate. And I ate, and I ate, and I ate. And I had gained about 45 kilograms in a year and a half. And although I was successful in this new enterprise, I wasn't that happy. I wasn't that happy with myself because I didn't want to be overweight. I didn't want to feel the way I did, but I just did. And this gentleman in St. Louis, the guy who owned the bakery, said to me, "I want you to try something." I said, "What?" He says, "I've got a diet for you that will make you lose your 45 kilograms within 6 months." I said, "No way, impossible." He said, "Bear with me." And we went to, brought home from his bake shop, cookies. Cookies? How are cookies going to help me lose weight? What a crazy idea. So he says to me, "Listen, eat a cookie as a meal replacement." And I said, "What do you mean?" "Well, a cookie contains more than 60% fiber. And the phenomenal thing about fiber is when fiber is mixed with water, it expands, and it can expand up to 4 times its size." So what happened was very easily. You ate a fiber cookie, you drank 2 glasses of water with it, and this little cookie blew up in your stomach, and you felt full, and it was phenomenal. So I got some cookies from him. They were free, of course. And what I did is I ate a cookie for breakfast, a cookie for lunch, and at dinner, I ate a healthy 1,000-calorie meal. And guess what, my friends? The weight started falling off, and falling off, and falling off. And although I had a very successful business, I was getting happier and happier. And my happiness was only because of my weight gain, and then my weight loss. It was exciting. So now I had the best of both worlds. I was feeling healthier, I was feeling better, and I was healthy financially, and healthy health-wise. And then the phenomenon happened. What happens if I could take this cookie and make it my own, and heck, sell it like we're selling water filters? What a phenomenal idea. I know how to sell through multi-level. And this was a product that certainly wouldn't sell on shelves of a store because you have to talk to people. You have to explain it to them. And that's what we are here. We're network marketers. We explain things to people. We bring things to people because people, that's our strength. And that's what we did. At that point, I decided to take the best from the marketing plan of the company I was with. And I had a lot of cookies baked, and on October 1st, 1989, we opened offices simultaneously in St. Louis, Missouri, and Toronto, Canada. And and lifestyle had officially begun. So all the products that you guys have today weren't invented. We had no clue about Nutria or Fiberlife or Intra. It didn't exist. Lifestyle started, listen to this, as the Diet Cookie Company. That was strange. Diet Cookie? And that was what's so phenomenal. A Diet Cookie. It was an oxymoron. It didn't make sense. How can a cookie be a diet? Well, again, you have to explain it to people, and that's where network marketing came in. And it was absolutely exciting. Our meetings were explosive because guess what? There was tons of emotion. Just like there's tons of emotion here when you drink our product, Intra, or when you take Nutria. You understand what I'm talking about. This was diet. And people were getting up on stage, and people were showing pictures of themselves before and after. This was a new phenomenon. Nobody had ever talked about diet, a before and after picture. This was in the 80s, remember. Diet was becoming popular. And we had a phenomenal way to market our product. We multiplied ourselves through network marketing. However, the emotionalism of the story made us grow. And boy, guys, did we grow. We grew so fast, so unexpected, we didn't know what hit us. We, in our first 2 years, ran out of product 4 times. And that's a no-no in this business. Because if you run out of product, you have nothing in the store, you don't make any money. And we just could not produce the cookies fast enough. We are selling in Canada. We are selling now big in the United States. And we decided to expand. In our first 2 years, we went to the UK. So that was the beginning of Lifestyles. It wasn't until many, many years later that we came to the Philippines. I think that was 15 years later. It was 10 years after we started, we came to Asia. But that was the beginning of Lifestyles. Now, let me tell you another little story, and then a quick one. Intra. Well, it's a very successful business, and we were growing really fast. But we had a problem with Lifestyles, and only we at head office understood the problem. And the problem was that all our speakers, all the people who were my GMDs at the time, they all showed these pictures before and after. But what happens when people go on diets? Quick diets, fad diets. What happens? You all know the answer. You lose the weight, and as soon as you get back onto any other routine, you gained it all back. So here we were, a year, year and a half into the business, and all my GMDs were big again. So they were standing on stage, and they were talking about weight loss, and they were big. It didn't work. It just didn't work. So, as I say, life throws you a few curves, and in business, same curves are happening. We needed something else. We needed a new product immediately. Because if we didn't have a new product, we didn't have a company. Cookies were still selling. Success, business was success. And then we moved to Australia. Now, this is a funny little story because the Australian government was the first government to say to us, you can't call a cookie a diet cookie. Doesn't make sense. So the government, after 1.5 years, forbade us to sell cookies ever again in Australia. Why? We called it a diet cookie. We couldn't do that. So with that impending problem, my distributors, who were my leaders, gaining weight, I remember when I was a child. When I was a little child, I had asthma. And boy, I remember I was intense. I couldn't, reading was a problem. And my mother took me to a herbologist, an old-fashioned Chinese herbologist. And what he gave me as a child was this terrible, I remember every day taking a tablespoon of this terrible tasting drink. But this terrible tasting drink made me feel better, made me breathe better. And this was herbs. So I was always interested for the rest of my life in herbs. And then the research started. Herbs. Okay, if that helped me, what can we do for other people? Well, I found out that every herb has a medicinal purpose. That's what it's all about. Prior to the 20th century, the 1800s or the 1700s, you were sick. We didn't have any medicine. We didn't have any pills to take. We went to herbologists. We went natural. That's how we took our, we'll call it medicine, we'll call it our healing powers, but herbs and barks and roots, they were the key. They were the key to helping people throughout centuries before modern medicine came. And then we got together with three herbologists and we came up with the formula. The formula, it's been around for a long, long time. It was 23 of the finest herbal extracts. Each single one having a purpose, a healing power. And that was what we call today Intra. Intra, I thought cookies were exciting. My friends, when we introduced Intra to the United States and Canada and the United Kingdom, within 2 years, we had 40, listen to me, 40 GMDs. So that's double what we had here in the Philippines. That was a long time ago, but that was based on cookies. So that was the story of how lifestyle started. And it was a good start. As you know, people, life is a choice. Life is a choice of what you do with it, for you, for your family, for people you love. That's why we do it. I'm sitting here and I'm listening to Sean. And I'm listening to what we have going. Pearl Farm. Cruises. What else was up there? It was so exciting. What we are doing as a company, we never dreamt of doing. We are letting people, you all guys know, travel international. We are making thousands upon thousands of people money. Success is all of yours. It's not the company's, it's all of yours. Because lifestyle, truly, as you're going to hear all afternoon, and as you saw this morning, lifestyle is an opportunity for you. For you and your family. Again, I'm very, very excited to be here. I want to thank you all so very much for being here. For giving us a chance to help you help yourself. I want to thank you all for coming today. And I will be back here in February for the ILC. My friends, the ILC is big. If any of you have never been to an ILC, it will be probably one of the most exciting things of your life. So I beg you, for your own sake, come. It's going to be an exciting event. Every time we do it, We can't believe how phenomenal an evening it is. So I look forward to seeing you all again in February. And keep selling intro. Thank you very much.
Drink Intra. Share Intra. Every day.
Pass it on!
Lifestyles. Live better every day.